sou sabe, bem para brincar, sou sabe, Melchior de Caentali, nem o maior bu pai, para cuchar que está ali. Sou sabe, bem para brincar, sou sabe. I'm so glad that you are here. I'm so glad. That is a Cape Verdean folk song. And here is a Cape Verdean folk tale. There's a character over there in Cape Verde Islands. His name is Nho Lobo. Can you say that? Nho Lobo. Nho Lobo is very, very tricky. Nho Lobo is cunning. Nho Lobo is lazy. Nho Lobo always wants something for nothing all the time. That's Nho Lobo. And he does not know how to work. He's so lazy, that Nho Lobo, that tricky Nho Lobo. They tell many stories about Nho Lobo over there in Cape Verde. Now, Nho Lobo, he has a nephew, and his nephew's name is Tabino. Can you say that? Tabino, yeah. Now, Tabino's, he's different than Nho Lobo. He's always working in the garden. He's working in the yard. He's fixing the fence, helping his neighbors. Always busy, 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 busy. That's Tabino. Now, there's another character over there. It's a monkey. And the monkey's name is Shabin. Can you say that? Shabin. Now, over in the Cape Verde Islands, the people there, they love to eat a certain root vegetable. It grows below the ground. It's called a manioc. Yes, manioc. Well, the story starts off with Tabino working in his garden. And whenever Tabino worked, he always sang his favorite song, which was, so sabe, ben para brincar, so sabe. I'm so glad. I'm so glad that you are here. I'm so glad. Today I'm going to plant some manioc. And I hope my lazy uncle, Nho Lobo, does not come by. For you see, Nho Lobo, he likes to eat. But he does not like to work. Ah, yeah. So Tabino went out into the garden and he started to plant some manioc. And he planted row upon manioc. Oh, I love to plant manioc. Oh, he's planting row upon row of manioc. When all of a sudden, off in the distance, he hears the voice of his uncle, Nho Lobo, singing his favorite song, which was, Aitunga, 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 aitunga. Ay, ay, it's Nho Lobo, Nho Lobo, bakasa, deca entali, don't you want to hear, deca entali, bakasa, go home, Nho Lobo, go home. Hey, Tabino, you're planting manioc. Yes, I'm planting manioc, but it's not for you. Go home, bakasa. No, Tabino, let me help you. You don't know anything about work. You just like to eat. I know how to plant manioc. Let me help you. Okay, uncle, but don't you eat any of my manioc. I won't. Come, let's get busy. And Tabino started to plant manioc once again, and Nho Lobo planted some manioc across the field. And Nho Lobo was planting, and Tabino was planting and planting. And as soon as Tabino turned around, Nho Lobo tiptoed across the field over to where Tabino was planting, and he started to eat the manioc. And then he went back to work planting manioc. Well, Tabino turned around and said, "Ay, Nho Lobo, you've eaten my manioc." "No, no, Tabino, I've been busy planting. Look at all the manioc I planted over here. No, I know I planted a row of manioc right here, and now they're gone. You've eaten it." "Tabino, you're out here working in this hot sun. You don't have a hat on your head. You're forgetting what you've done. Tabino, why don't you go home and rest? I will finish planting for you." "You will plant for me?"
"Yes, yes, go ahead. Bakasa, bakasa."
And Tabino went, bakasa. As soon as Tabino was gone, Nho Lobo ate all the manioc. Every one of them. Ate all the manioc. And then Nho Lobo walked home rubbing his belly singing, "Aitunga, aitunga, 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 aitunga." Well, finally, Tabino came back to the field and he looked and he said, "Aya, ayaya. That Nho Lobo, that lazy uncle of mine, he ate all my manioc. He's always fooling me, you know. Aya, I have to get even with him." And Tabino, he thought of a plan. And he went down to the docks where the boats were tied. And he got some rope. And he placed the rope over his shoulders. And then Tabino walked up that mountain trail by Nho Lobo's house. And Nho Lobo, he was sleeping on the porch. Tabino walked by and stamped his feet and made some noise. Nho Lobo saw Tabino rush by and said, "Hey, Tabino, spera, spera, wait, spera. Where are you going in such a hurry? You haven't heard, Uncle?" "No, I've been sleeping." "Well, Uncle, while you've been sleeping, a big storm has been gathering. The wind is going to be so ferocious. Anything that's not tied down is going to get blown far, far away." "Yeah, yeah. So I have this rope. I'm going to tie myself to this banana tree so I don't get blown far away." "Oh, nephew, tie me to that tree." "Oh, no, Uncle. This is the only rope I have." "Ay, coitad, I'm a poor thing. Coitad, please." I told you Nho Lobo was convincing. Well, he convinced Tabino to tie him up to that banana tree. As soon as Tabino agreed to tie Nho Lobo up, Nho Lobo started giving orders. "Tommy, good and tight now. Come on, tighter than that. Good and tight. Tighter than that." And Tabino, he tied Nho Lobo good and tight to that tree. And then Tabino said, "Okay, Uncle, I have to go get some more rope for myself." And Tabino went, "Bakasa." Well, Nho Lobo was waiting underneath that tree, and he's waiting and waiting. And he looked up in the tree, and he saw Shabin, the monkey. Nho Lobo said, "Eba, Eba, Shabin, Eba." Now, Shabin was ignoring Nho Lobo because he knew all about Nho Lobo. "Shabin, hey, Shabin, can I have one banana?" "Oi, coitad, please, I'm a poor thing, please." Well, I told you Nho Lobo was convincing. Well, he convinced Shabin to give him one banana. "Oh, Obrigado, Shabin. Obrigado. Thank you. Obrigado. Uno mas. Uno mas. One more. Oh. Obrigado, Shabin. Uno mas. Oh. Obrigado, Shabin. Oh. Hey, Shabin, do you see any clouds up in the sky?" "No." "Do you feel any wind or rain?" "No." "You know, I think my nephew fooled me. He told me a storm was coming. I allowed him to tie me to this banana tree because he said anything not tied down is going to get blown far away. And now I think it's not funny, Shabin. Don't you laugh at me, Shabin." "Oh, no, I'm not angry with you, Shabin. Oh, no, you're my friend." "Oh, yeah, I always speak well of you, Shabin. Hey, Shabin, will you untie me?" "Oh, coitad, please, Shabin, please." I told you Nho Lobo was convincing. Well, he convinced Shabin to come down and untie him. Well, Shabin came down and he untied Nho Lobo's arms. And then he untied Nho Lobo's hands. And then he untied Nho Lobo's feet. And as soon as he was done tying Nho Lobo's feet, Nho Lobo jumped down and grabbed the hold of Shabin. "I got you now, Shabin. I'm going to eat you up. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to eat you up." Just then, Tabino came back. Nho Lobo looked at Tabino and said, "Yeah, you tried to fool me, huh? Tell me a storm was coming, yeah. But look here, I've got this monkey. I'm going to eat Shabin. And I'm not going to share it with you." "That's okay, Uncle. But Uncle, do you know the best way to prepare a monkey?" "The best way?" "Yeah." "Well, how?" "Well, you take that monkey and you tie him up with that rope. And then you throw the monkey high in the air. The higher, the better. When that monkey comes down, open your mouth nice and wide and swallow that monkey in one gulp. Tastes good." "Yeah, yeah." And Tabino went, "Bakasa." Well, Nho Lobo, he tied up Shabin. And he went, "One, two, three." And he threw Shabin way up in the air, way up in the air. At least he thought he threw Shabin way up in the air. Shabin landed in the tree. But Nho Lobo did not see him land in the tree. Nho Lobo, he was waiting like this. Ah, 5 minutes. Ah, 10 minutes. Ah, 15 minutes. Ah, 20 minutes. Finally, Tabino came back and said, "Nho Lobo, you're still waiting?" "Yes." "You know, Uncle, you are so strong. You threw up that monkey so high, the wind is going to blow it over to America. And if I were you, I would rush over to America and get your food before someone else gets it for you." "Oh, okay." And Nho Lobo, he ran down to the docks. But all the ships were gone, even the Ernestina. But that did not stop Nho Lobo. Nho Lobo dove into the water, and he swam and he swam and he swam clear out of sight. And that's the last time anyone on the Cape Verde Islands ever saw Nho Lobo. But rumor has it, if you should visit places in southeastern New England, or the great whaling seaport of New Bedford, Massachusetts, or you go down to Wareham and Marion, or parts of Providence, Rhode Island, and Pawtucket, Rhode Island, or down by the cranberry bogs in the Cape, you might see someone walking around like this. Ah, that's Nho Lobo.